Vitamin E deficiency is rare but can occur, particularly in people with certain health conditions or dietary issues. Vitamin E is a fat-soluble antioxidant that helps protect cells from oxidative damage. It plays a role in immune function, skin health, and maintaining cell membranes. Conditions like Crohn's disease, cystic fibrosis, and certain liver diseases can reduce the absorption of fat, which is essential for vitamin E uptake. Rare genetic disorders, such as abetalipoproteinemia and familial isolated vitamin E deficiency, can prevent the body from properly absorbing and using vitamin E. Babies born prematurely may be at risk due to their underdeveloped digestive systems and low body weight. Very low-fat diets or a diet lacking foods like nuts, seeds, leafy greens, and vegetable oils can lead to low vitamin E intake. Symptoms vary depending on severity, but often include neurological symptoms such as ataxia or loss of coordination, muscle weakness, and peripheral neuropathy, presenting as tingling and numbness in the limbs. Vitamin E deficiency can lead to retinal damage, resulting in vision impairment, weakened immunity, hemolytic anemia due to oxidative damage to red blood cells, particularly in infants. Long-term deficiency can lead to muscle weakness and damage. To diagnose vitamin E deficiency, neurological examination is done to assess for signs of neuropathy or coordination issues. Measuring alpha-tocopherol levels in the blood is the most common diagnostic method. For patients with suspected genetic causes, genetic testing may confirm mutations associated with ataxia with vitamin E deficiency. Since vitamin E is fat-soluble, assessing fat absorption can help determine if there's an absorption issue. The primary treatment is supplementation with vitamin E supplements, either orally or intravenously in severe cases. Incorporating vitamin E-rich foods like almonds, sunflower seeds, spinach, and avocados can support recovery. Addressing the primary causes of malabsorption, like managing Crohn's disease or cystic fibrosis, can improve vitamin E levels. Special formulas and supplements may be given to infants at risk of or with confirmed deficiency. And that's all for this video. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more informative health content. Stay tuned for our next video.